I'm in Northern California. It's a remote and rugged wilderness. It's home to the famous redwood trees. You see them everywhere. But I'm here to check out the local farming industry. It's one that employs about 30,000 people, and it's been the lifeblood of the local economy here for generations. But all this might go up in smoke if it were made legal. This isn't a story about being pro or anti-drugs. It's about the economics of the black market.
This area of the world produces the most cannabis out of any other region.
Well, most of them were called hippies, dirtbags.
The driver shot the passenger in the head and killed him and then put a gun in his mouth and pulled the trigger.
We don't want to see all these small farms disappear because we know this is the best way to grow this medicine.
Humboldt County is about 5 hours north of San Francisco and about 50 years behind it.
You can't live around here long without gaining a little attachment to this country. It's a beautiful place to live.
Old-timer Ernie Branscombe is one of the few that remember Humboldt's first boom.
When I was a kid, loggers were heroes. I mean, they were the people that were building America. Most everybody in my family ended up in one way or another in the timber industry. I was driving bulldozer in the woods when I was 8 years old. I'd say sawdust is in my blood. Logging was Humboldt County. I mean, I loved logging. I'd still be doing it if there was a way to do it.
But overlogging brought new environmental protection laws that saw the decline of the industry in the 60s. The timber folk left. In their place came the Back to the Land movement. A free spirit for a gout.
Well, most of them were called hippies, dirtbags. They were pretty seriously different. I think it was culture clash, to say the least.
With them came the seeds of what would sprout into Humboldt's economic savior.
When we talked about losing the timber industry, we thought we were all going to die. Well, that didn't happen. The marijuana industry came in as the timber industry went out.
Loggers and ranchers and these people who were like members of the like conservative kind of frontier families that like founded the culture and were at first just completely flabbergasted and repulsed by these like young people who were like, you know, had long hair and swam naked in the river and stuff. They got into the marijuana industry too because it was this way to stay in their communities and earn a healthy living. And it just became something that everybody was doing.
This is Humboldt County's biggest annual festival, which just happens to coincide with the annual outdoor growing season, or the start of it anyway. But it's here that you really understand how big a part marijuana plays in the lives of people that live here in Humboldt. The US government spent millions of dollars trying to stamp out production, even deploying active duty US troops against their own citizens.
In Northern California, the marijuana task force is about to hit a massive Mexican cartel pot grow.
When the 80s hit and Just Say No and Reagan, we couldn't even get the drug warriors to debate us in a public forum. It was just about, you know, trying to keep people out of prison.
But then reformists like Ellen Comp succeeded in what was then a landmark decision. California became the first state to legalize marijuana for medical use under Proposition 215 or the Compassionate Use Act. Legitimate farms popped up all over California. It continues to directly contradict federal law by allowing for a small amount of marijuana to be grown or smoked through state-authorized medical avenues.
It's very interesting right now. I mean, you know, we've had legal medical marijuana in California since 1996, and since then it's been a process of deciding who, what, and where. And ultimately we're heading towards a full legalization for the ballot in 2016.
But Californians already said no to full legalization in a 2010 ballot. Colorado and Washington have since greenlit recreational use in their states, overtaking the once progressive California.
Cloud of protection.
Something doesn't add up here. Why is California, America's most liberal, fight for your right to party state, opposed to marijuana legalization? The answer is good old-fashioned capitalism. Like the loggers that were sidelined by environmental ideologies, the hippies have been sidelined by economic ones. Their own children now exploiting California's medical loophole on a grand and greedy scale. While many people farm and sell medical marijuana, the vast majority here are in fact supplying the black market. Legalisation would see the price per pound drop by about half. It would attract unwanted taxes and open the market to big tobacco and big pharma, who are already lobbying government for their legalisation models that would see big agro business dwarf Humboldt's boutique brand.
When something is illegal, it props up the prices in the black market. And marijuana is like our most popular illegal drug. And people up there call it like the best government price control program in US history. So you have, you know, a plant that's worth, you know, almost $1,500 a pound. And like tomatoes are like, what, three or something, you know? So it's pretty crazy. And that basically the sheriff and like law enforcement is for legalization, and the majority of growers are against legalization. And I think that's a really good point.
And it's places like this where the money from the weed industry becomes legitimized in community businesses selling everything from agricultural supplies to, yes, big old American pickup trucks. This new breed are called hipnecks, hippie rednecks, whose annual outdoor crops can be worth up to $2 million. It's a farming model that's high risk and high gain. But it's not just agribusiness and truck dealerships that benefit from the weed industry. Local services like hospitals and volunteer firefighting are dependent on weed revenue. You see, keeping track of the law is a favourite pastime of the local weed farmers. And there's one thing that's quicker than the Bush Telegraph.
Hello and welcome to the local news for Thursday,
North
July 3rd.
Was arrested for possession of drug paraphernalia, possession of illicit
drugs.
Reporting from the heart of the Emerald Triangle, I'm Carrie Reynolds.
KMUD or Kmart is the local community-supported radio station who directly benefits from cash donations from the farmers. They provide up-to-the-minute news on busts and law enforcement information.
I'm here today with Andy Pack from Australia. Did I say your name right?
No, it's Park, but I get that all the time. You can call me Andy Pack.
All right, Andy. Well, why don't you tell us a little bit about what you're doing here in Humboldt County?
It's an unusual situation here in Humboldt County, and I think it's really interesting. From some of your programs I've listened to online, it seems like there's a real debate going on at the moment, a fork in the road, if you like, for those that support legalization and those that don't.
I think one of the main benefits of cannabis being illegal is it's kept corporations out. It's prevented this consolidation that's occurred in all the other agricultural commodities. We want to protect our community. We don't want to see all these small farms disappear because we know this is the best way to grow this medicine. In small scale is the best way to just produce the best product.
Today, I'm going on patrol with a veteran of the Humboldt County Sheriff's Department. He's taking me to the site where the ugly underbelly of Humboldt's weed industry was exposed late one night.
My whole career has really been as a result of marijuana in this county. Marijuana created a job for me back in 1986. It's a pretty big change in the last 28 years from where we've gone to where we are now.
This halfway law, you know, the Compassionate Use Act, I mean, in a lot of ways, it's created a lot of problems for the Sheriff's Department, has it not?
We throw a great deal of resources at the issue of marijuana, and 69.8% of our homicide cases are directly related in one way to marijuana growth. It can be kind of the Wild West in a way.
It's just gorgeous out here.
Oh, it's beautiful.
And it just goes for miles. I mean, it is.
I mean, how many growers would be out where we can see now?
Well, they're out there.
In these lonely hills, Humboldt farmer Michael Wild had a 1,500 plant garden in the summer of 2010. As any farmer will tell you, turning a profit in a drought is tough going. And when his illegal agribusiness began to run out of water, he had to let staff go.
the operation lost steam, lost money. There was a real issue with bringing water in. The grower decided that the best way to deal with these two immigrants was to kill them, and he did. He killed one and shot the other, and he got away. He actually got shot, I think, through the mouth.
So if water was such an issue in this crime scene, mm-hmm. what do you expect this summer's growth season when the drought is so bad here in California?
It's going to be bad. I expect a lot of problems.
Now that we're in 2014, when we hear about the war on drugs, I mean, where's that at?
As far as marijuana is concerned, I think it's a losing battle.
So how much easier would your job be if marijuana was legalized in California?
Well, it would certainly divert our resources, wouldn't it?
This is what makes Humboldt and, to a larger extent, California so complicated. There are many legal growers here and thousands more illegal ones, making it virtually impossible to police.
Sheriff Downey, Andy Park, nice to meet you. Thanks very much.
You almost have to feel sorry for the man tasked with enforcing a federal law, which is partially legal on a state level, and that no one seems to abide by anyway.
Trying to put it together in a patchwork has not worked well for the United States or for California itself. We are, I'll use the word suffering, from an ill-conceived law. To me, it's either you're all in or you're all out. I'm down to two options. Legalization makes perfect sense. The other option, and there's only two, like I said, is to fully fund our eradication efforts. But right now, it's very cloudy, very murky as to where we go with this.
This is a veg room.
Even legal medical growers like Mary Ellen acknowledge that the current law that sees her business thrive is broken and abused.
The original intent was, we have cancer patients, we have AIDS patients that could really benefit from using cannabis with wasting syndrome and all the other things that go on with the disease. And so it started because of that. And then it was like, you know, and you could take care of your grandmother and have a little grow. And then it just turned into this whole other thing. So it's all through the back door. And now nobody knows how to really stop it.
And here's the rub. The price per pound has already dropped since Colorado and Washington legalized.
Oh, probably about 5 years ago, you get $4,000 a pound for an indoor grow, and now you're getting like $22 to $25.
She's unsure of her place in the new market.
Some people are thinking it'll be more like down in the wine country, where they have specialty things that they're growing. The whole other issue in our town of all the people that are growing. You know, there's kids coming out of high school, or not even graduating from high school, and they can go work up at the Hill and make $90,000 in 3 months.
But here, workers in the legal medical marijuana industry don't make nearly as much, as I'm about to find out.
So Mary Ellen has given me a job in the trim department. That's where the buds are kind of trimmed of all the excess leaves that don't have the active ingredient, the THC, that you really want. It's just in here.
You got it upside down there.
Trimmer Mike has been tasked with teaching me the trade.
And then you just want to take the big fan leaves off.
Like this?
Yep.
Every summer, thousands of young people flock to Humboldt to work trimming weed. It's a perfectly legal job, just like fruit picking in Australia.
What do you tend to get paid per hour as a trimmer?
Well, you don't get paid per the hour. You normally get paid by how much you trim.
Okay. And is it good money?
It can be, depending on how fast you are and how good the product is.
So at this rate, how much would I make a day?
You'd be making pennies. A little shaggy, but that'll do.
For a first timer.
Yeah.
Humboldt, and California for that matter, stands at a fork in the road for a county that has more at stake than just drug politics.
Yeah, it'll become legal in California. I don't see any way around it.
When you build a utopia in America, at some point you have to make a reckoning with capitalism.
I think it is inevitable. I think that you will see a decrease in the profitability of it.
If California fully legalizes marijuana in 2016, as many believe they will, Humboldt County, the original home of weed in the United States, will never be the same again.
There's a really popular saying in Humboldt when it comes to marijuana growing, which is like, it's what we do here. It is the lifeblood of the economy.